In this video, we will talk about how to find a basic feasible solution, or BFS, to the balanced transportation problem using the minimum cost method. There are three steps. In step 1, we need to find the cell with the smallest unit cost in the transportation tableau. Ties are broken arbitrarily, which means if there are two or more cells with the same smallest unit cost, randomly select one of them. Then, allocate as much as possible to the selected cell and adjust the associated amounts of supply and demand by subtracting the allocated amount. In step 2, we cross out the row or column with zero supply or demand. If both a row and a column have a zero, randomly cross out one only. In step 3, if exactly one cell is left uncrossed, cross out the cell and stop. Otherwise, we need to go back to step 1 and repeat the process. For example, this is a transportation tableau. The unit transportation cost is shown in the top right corner of each cell, like 2, 3, 5, 6, and so on. The total supply for the first row is 5. For the second row is 10, and so on. The total demand for the first column is 12. For the second column is 8, and so on. Now in the first step, we need to find the cell with the minimum unit cost, which is this cell with the unit cost of 1. We need to allocate as much as possible to this cell and subtract the allocated amount from supply S2 and demand D2. The largest amount we can allocate is 8, because if we allocate more than 8, D2 will be changed to a negative number. We put number 8 here and subtract it from D2 and S2. D2 will be 0, S2 will be 2. This is the new tableau. In step 2, we cross out the row or column with 0 supply or demand. In this case, only D2 is 0. We will cross out the second column and remove D2. Now we need to check step 3. Do we have only one cell left? No, we have many cells left. We need to go to step 1 and repeat the process. Now we need to find the cell with the minimum cost in the remaining tableau. We have a tie, 2 and 2. I randomly select this cell. The largest amount we can allocate to this cell is 2, because if we allocate more than 2, S2 will be negative. We put 2 here and subtract it from S2 and D1. S2 will be 0, D1 will be 10. This is the new tableau. We need to cross out the second row and remove S2 because S2 is 0. Let's continue with the process. Find the cell with the minimum cost in the remaining tableau, which is this cell. The largest amount we can allocate is 5. We put 5 here and subtract it from S1 and D1. S1 will be 0 and D1 will be 5. This is the new tableau. We need to cross out the first row and remove S1 because S1 is 0. Continue with the process. Find the cell with the minimum cost in the remaining tableau, which is this cell. The largest amount we can allocate is 5. We put 5 here and subtract it from S3 and D1. S3 will be 10, D1 will be 0. This is a new tableau. D1 is equal to 0. We can cross out the first column and remove D1. Repeat the process. Find the cell with the minimum cost in the remaining tableau, which is this cell. The largest amount we can allocate is 4. We put 4 here, subtract it from S3 and D3. S3 will be 6, D3 will be 0. This is the new tableau. D3 is equal to 0. We will cross out this column and remove D3. We have only one cell left. We just allocate the remaining amount, which is 6, to this cell, and cross out this row and this column, and remove F3 and D4. This is the final tableau. Remember, this is just a basic feasible solution. It's a starting point. It's not the final optimal solution to the balanced transportation problem yet. How do we interpret this basic feasible solution? It means x11 is equal to 5, x2, 1 is equal to 2, and so on and so forth. All other ij in the blank cells are equal to 0. If you wonder if this really is a basic feasible solution, you can check whether it satisfies all the equality constraints. Let's bring back the original supply and demand. The sum of the first row, 5, is equal to 5. The sum of the second row, 2 plus 8, is equal to 10. Sum of the third row, 5 plus 4 plus 6, is equal to 15. The sum of the first column, 5 plus 2 plus 5, is equal to 12. Sum of the second column, 8, is equal to 8. Sum of the third column, 4, is equal to 4. Sum of the last column, 6, is equal to 6. So all the constraints are satisfied. This is indeed a basic feasible solution. The advantage of using the minimum cost method is that it utilizes the cost information and the generated basic feasible solution may be closer to the optimal solution. But this method requires a little bit more computational effort than the northwest corner method. Sometimes it may still generate a basic feasible solution with extremely high cost, which is far away from the optimal solution. Okay, that's how we find a basic feasible solution to the balanced transportation problem using the minimum cost method. Thanks for watching.